Welcome back again to another mini lecture on the series History of Anesthesia. In the name of Almighty Allah, let's get started. Today, our topic is History of Anesthesia, Local and Regional Anesthetic Era. Right? The time when we learn to numb the pain right at its source. Now, let's recap what we studied previously. So, first, we talked about the inhalation era. Right? We talked about inhaled gases like ether, chloroform, nitrous oxide, right? How they cause it systemic toxicity and were flammable, right? Now we are going to know how the anesthesia evolved over time to the local regional anesthesia where we targeted pain right at its source. So let's move ahead. Let's define local versus regional anesthesia. So the regional anesthesia numbs a large area by targeting major nerves or the spinal cord, example spinal, epidural, Bier block, plexus blocks. So in the regional anesthesia, we mainly target on the larger sections of our body, right? Techniques includes spinal, epidural, Bier block, plexus block, right? And in the local anesthesia, we numb a small area, for example, for tooth extraction or minor skin procedures. The term regional anesthesia was popularized by Harvey Cushing in the 20th century. Harvey Cushing made the world known to techniques of regional anesthesia. So now let's move ahead. So now let's talk about the timeline of the local anesthetics and the year in which they were introduced. So here is the tabular form of this. So I will be particularly focusing on the main or the key local anesthetics like cocaine, procaine, lidocaine, bupivacaine, and ropivacaine. So these drugs have different profiles and they vary in their toxicity. That's the harmful effect and the onset and duration, right? For example, if I talk about the lidocaine, it is fast acting. Its duration is about for 1 to 2 hours. While as bupivacaine, it has a slower onset and it has a longer duration of action. So based on this, we will be looking on each scenario where we will be using different anesthetics. Like for example, if we have to perform a minor surgery, we'll be using that anesthetic, which has a shorter duration. For example, if we have a dental surgery, we will be using what? We'll be using lidocaine. And if we have a longer procedure surgery, we'll be using bupivacaine. So now let's move ahead and talk about our first local anesthetic, cocaine. It was Karl Koller who discovered cocaine's anesthetic properties and introduced it in 1884, right? So he used a 2% cocaine solution to perform eye surgery. So this revolutionized the surgeries, minor surgeries, dentistry, right? And but it brought with it some downsides, like it was toxic and was highly addictive, right? Now let's move ahead. A better and safer alternative of cocaine, procaine or novocaine, a safer alternative. Okay, in 1905, Alfred Einhorn synthesizes the procaine, a less toxic alternative of cocaine. Advantages was that it was non-addictive and it had same effect as was seen in cocaine. While used in dentistry and minor surgery, so it became a dentist's best friend. So limitations were that it had shorter duration of action. Okay, so now let's move ahead and talk about our key local anesthetics, lidocaine, bupivacaine and ropivacaine. So lidocaine, it has a faster onset, duration is 1 to 2 hours. Toxicity is moderate, means it's harmful when administered to the patient in large doses. The toxic effect is could be like arrhythmia, shock, seizures, right? Common uses include minor surgery, nerve block, bupivacaine. Its onset is slow, duration is 4 to 8 hours, and toxicity risk is high. It shows cardiac toxicity. It is used in epidurals and prolonged surgeries. Okay, ropivacaine, onset is slower, duration is 4 to 6 hours and its toxicity is low, and it is used, commonly used in labor, epidurals and chronic pain. The fun fact, even today we are using the lidocaine as our gold standard for comparing the new anesthetics that are coming in use. We are comparing with the lidocaine in terms of it is duration, it is toxicity, right? The clinical tip is that when we inject bupivacaine, we always aspirate so that we make sure that the drug we are injecting is in the epidural space and not in the intravesicular, as it may cause cardiac toxicity, right? Arrhythmias, right? Now let's move ahead. Now let's talk about another technique, that's limb block, also known as plexus block, like our brachial plexus block, pioneered by James Leonard Corning in 1885, right? It is used to numb the arm. For numbing the leg, we will be using lambosacral plexus block in order to perform surgery of leg. We'll be using lambosacral plexus block. Advantage was that now for minor surgery, we don't have to put the patient under sleep, right? Moving ahead to our spinal and epidural anesthesia. Spinal anesthesia in 1898, our Auguste Bier pioneered the spinal anesthesia. So he injected cocaine, right? Anesthetic injected into cerebrospinal fluid. It had quick onset and used it for short procedures. So it was a self experiment, and after that he developed a severe spinal headache, right? Okay, now epidural anesthesia was developed later for childbirth and lower body surgery. So spinal anesthesia is used to numb the areas below the waist, like the abdomen, pelvis, lower limb, and also in case of epidurals. But in epidurals, we have a more control over the area we are numbing, right? So advantages was that now the patient could remain awake. So as I said, there was it reduced the need for the general anesthesia. Fun fact, August Bier experiment caused the first spinal headache. Now let's move to our next technique, that is IVRA, intravenous regional anesthesia, or Bier block. Okay, so 1908, August Bier, the same person who developed the technique of spinal anesthesia. So in 1908, August Bier develops IVRA. He applied a tourniquet arm and then he injected the local anesthetic into the limb. So there was a numbness over the area, and we could now perform a pain-free surgery. We could repair the wrist or whatever the problem was there. Uses short procedure on arm or leg. Similarly, it can be used for leg, right? And limitations was that it had short duration of action. And once the tourniquet was removed, the drug would wash out and the numbness would wear off, right? And moreover, the discomfort that was associated with a tourniquet. The Bier block is named after August Bier, the same doctor who pioneered spinal anesthesia. Now let's talk about the impact on the surgery. Before, general anesthesia required even for minor surgery. Now there was faster recovery and targeted pain relief. For example, for childbirth, orthopedic surgeries, risks and ethical considerations. Even though we got targeted pain relief, but it brought some risks with it. Like in rare cases, it caused nerve damage or infections at the site of injection or systemic toxicity when injected in large doses. So the ethical focus should always be that we provide the patient with the risks and provide an informed consent. Right, now let's talk about the legacy of the regional anesthesia, the contributions and the improvements. So the development of safer local anesthetics like lidocaine and bupivacaine, improved techniques for nerve blocks and epidurals, ultrasounded guided precision. So now we begin ultrasounded guided precisions to block to provide nerve blocks. These advancements have transformed how we approach pain management today. Fun fact, earlier versions of Coca-Cola contained cocaine. That's why the name, right? So it was removed later on because of the health concerns. So now let's talk about the summary and the preview. So cocaine's legacy paved the way for safer local anesthetics that are used today. Spinal and epidural breakthrough. These methods revolutionized pain control during surgeries and childbirth. Limb blocks, these lower the need for general anesthesia in targeted procedures. So innovations, continuous advancements now focus on precision, and patient safety improvements. In the next lecture, we are going to talk about the intravenous anesthetic era. We're talking about barbiturates, thiopentanol, propofol, and the shift from inhalation to intravenous anesthesia. So thank you for joining me. See you in the next lecture. Till then, keep learning.